welcome to the second episode of NIWFA Television, the weekly review show of the Northern Ireland Women's Football Association.
Our action this week sees us make our first visit of the season to the Electric Ireland South 1 Division, with our feature game seeing Belfast Celtic Ladies take on Bangor Ladies.
Both sides went into this game with wins under their belt from match day one, so there was certainly a lot of stake on the outcome of this game.
Here's the highlights.
What did you think of that one?
Good game, very, very closely contested. There wasn't much between the two sides. All credit to Bangor Ladies, who sort of went a goal down, kept fighting and fighting, and eventually got the reward by pulling back two, not just one, but two goals and turning the game on its head.
Yeah, Belfast Celtic had the lead for quite a time, unfortunately concede.
Yeah, it is. I mean, from any team's perspective, when you're leading 1-0 for a long time, you like to see the finish line get over. But in this case, just at the end, they were pegged back and Bangor took the result.
This week we saw three goals.
Yep.
What did you think of their finishes?
Not too bad. The finishes were well taken. The first one got a bit of a deflection, caught the keeper off guard a little bit. But, you know, if you don't buy the ticket, you can't win the lottery.
Absolutely. Well, after the game, we caught up with players from both teams to see how the game had gone, and here's what they had to say.
Thought first half we were kind of slow to start, let them play into it. They got that good goal. At least we got the half time, kept it 1-0, but second half I thought we came out fighting. Really did. Last season, maybe it's not so much, we wouldn't have turned it around, but today the girls all worked the shirt off their back for each other. It's great to see it.
We hopefully keep winning. As Laura had stated, we had a bit of a tough league last year.
A bit more rebuilding last year.
If we lost it, we dropped our heads and we didn't come back, whereas the past two games we've won 1-0 down to come back up and score the goal and come back with a win. So we're looking to progress from there and build on our training and build a better squad, stronger squad, and look to get the wins and keep winning.
Well, obviously it's disappointing. Well, to be fair, this is our first season up in this league and feel like it's disappointing and a wee bit disheartening too. Like after going 1-0 up, thought we had a good advantage. This is our second time playing this team. Obviously the first time we were winning 2-0 and then they came back and won. We're hoping to get back at them this time, but unfortunately we didn't. There's a lot of things we need to learn on and work on. So like I said, this is our first season up, so we need to take everything into consideration and work hard as a team at the football, how we play on the pitch, and just come back bigger and stronger.
Welcome to your life. Help me make the most of freedom and of pleasure. Nothing ever lasts forever. Everybody wants to rule the world.
It's time now to have a brief look at the results elsewhere from the games played across the Electric Iron Leagues since our last episode.
In the Championship, Carn Money Ladies got off to a flyer with a great win over Ballymena All-Stars, with high-flying Cumberrec also narrowly defeating the All-Stars on Wednesday night. Elsewhere, Lurgan Ladies took the points in a high-scoring game against East Belfast Ladies.
In our featured league for this week, South 1, we have already saw Bangor Ladies securing victory for the 3 points against Belfast Celtic Ladies, and there was also a win for the ladies of Downpatrick.
North 1 saw Armagh City Ladies rack up a second consecutive win, whilst Middle Ulster Ladies secured their first points of the season with an encouraging 3-1 win over Crewe United Ladies. And finally, in North 2, the match between Chimney Corner Ladies and Debutants Larne Ladies ended all square in a 1-1 draw. So, Colin, things are starting to take shape across all the divisions.
Yeah, very much so. At this stage in time we're recording the show, we've got three teams with 100% records who have taken 6 points out of a possible six. Cumberrec Ladies, who have started the season very, very well at the new level they're playing at. Armagh City Ladies and Bangor Ladies, who we covered the other night, both on maximum points. All three on maximum points.
We've covered two games so far. They've been competitive. We've seen goals.
Get the impression, you know, it's... I haven't watched the teams. There's not an awful lot between the sides, to be honest. And I think it went for a very interesting season. Yes, you have your early pace setters, but it's a marathon, not a sprint.
Absolutely, yeah.
And we're going to mention this time at Tiarna's predictions, which haven't been exactly perfect so far. Last week, she predicted it would be a draw. It wasn't. This week, she said that the ladies of Belfast Celtic would win. They didn't. So, can you go much better?
Things can only get better.
Well, I'll believe it when I see it. We'll take it week by week. If you would like to get in touch with us here at NIWFA Television, please feel free to come over and say hello at any of the games. Or indeed, just drop us an email at the address now shown on the screen and we'll make sure to give you a shout out on the show.
In the meantime, thanks so much for watching today's show and for supporting women's football in Northern Ireland.
Until the next time, it's bye for now, but don't forget,
girls get football.